Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. It takes energy to go places, to power our electrical devices, and to make the products that we use every day. A lot of the energy we use comes to our electrical outlets by high-voltage power lines that start at power plants. But where do power plants get their energy to make electricity? In this video, we'll review the major energy sources and give a brief introduction of how electric generators work. There are two major groups of energy sources, renewable and non-renewable. Non-renewable energy sources include oil, natural gas, coal, and nuclear. Oil, natural gas, and coal are the remains of plants and tiny organisms, such as plankton, that lived millions of years ago. We call them fossil fuels because we find them by digging deep into the ground, much like we find other fossils, such as dinosaur bones. With the exception of a small fraction of cars and trains, all transportation depends on oil. Oil is deep underground in a form called crude oil. Companies pump up crude oil, then take it to an oil refinery where it is refined into gasoline for cars and boats, refined into diesel for semi-trucks and trains, and refined into jet fuel for planes and helicopters. Natural gas is often pumped from the same places as oil. It is a very affordable way to make heat. This comes into our homes in underground pipes, and we can then burn it in our furnaces or use it in our stoves. There are huge collections of coal in some parts of the world, and companies use enormous machines to mine it. The coal is then taken to power plants where it is burned to make hot fires that turn liquid water into high-pressure steam. That steam powers electric generators, which make electricity. Companies mine uranium by digging up certain areas of the ground and then extracting the uranium. That uranium is used as fuel in nuclear power plants to make hot fires that turn liquid water into high-pressure steam. That steam powers electric generators, which make electricity. Collectively, we call fossil fuels and nuclear power non-renewable energy sources. That phrase means that there is a limited supply. Once we have pumped up or mined these energy sources from the Earth, there will be no more left for a long time. The other group of energy sources are called renewable. That means that there is an endless supply because most of these depend on sunlight, the wind, or heat inside the Earth. There are many types of renewable energy sources, so we'll just discuss the major ones. Hydroelectric plants use the power of water falling from a high-level lake to a low-level river to turn turbines. Famous ones include the Hoover Dam in Nevada and part of the water diverted from Niagara Falls. In this animation, we can see falling water rotates a turbine shaft that in turn powers an electric generator. Geysers are an example of natural hot water. There are many places with hot water or steam underground that companies use to power electric generators. We call this geothermal energy. Windmills use the wind to power electric generators. A single one can make enough electricity to support a small town. Some are offshore, where the wind is stronger. They use cables to send the electricity back to the land. Solar cells can be small enough to fit on a calculator or big enough to cover a table. They convert the energy in sunlight directly into electricity. Solar panels can be put on a house or on an office building, so can give electricity to the outlets inside. Electric companies may own large fields of solar panels and connect them to power lines. Solar thermal energy systems use an array of mirrors to shine sunlight at a central tower. That heat is used to turn liquid water into high-pressure steam. That steam powers electric generators, which make electricity. Just like we can use wood to boil water when we're camping, we can use it to make hot fires that turn liquid water into high-pressure steam. That steam powers electric generators, which make electricity. Biomass energy is the name for burning freshly cut trees or grass to make electricity. We've reviewed a lot of energy sources. If you want to memorize a short list, just remember the four non-renewables, and that the other energy sources are renewables. One way to remember what renewable means is to think of borrowing a book from a library. Let's say that you didn't have time to read the whole book, so you renew it. That means you get to have it longer. Likewise, a renewable energy source is one that we get to have longer than a non-renewable energy source. Here's a review of energy sources. Please pause this video if you wish. Except for solar panels, which can make electricity directly from sunlight. Power plants use electric generators to make electricity. Here's a simple electric generator that we can power with our hands to light this bulb. An electric generator has two things: a magnetic field and one or more spools of copper wire. There is a magnet inside each of these posts, which makes a strong magnetic field between them. When this copper wire spins inside this magnetic field, the copper wire gets an electric current inside it. That's electricity that we can use. Power plants use electric generators that have a slightly different design than this one, but use the same principle of movement between copper wires and a magnetic field to make electricity. To make electricity, the spinning part has to be rotated very fast, and it takes a lot of energy to do that. A common way to spin the central part is to connect it to a shaft that has large blades on it, much like we saw inside this hydroelectric dam. Another way is to boil liquid water so it becomes high-pressure steam, then direct that steam against the blades of a turbine, which rotate a shaft connected to the electric generator. It takes energy to boil liquid water into steam, which is why we need an energy source like burning coal, as coal power plants do, or burning wood, as biomass plants do, or using the Earth's heat, as geothermal plants do, or by using heat from uranium fuel like nuclear plants do. Electricity that powers our TVs and other devices is not made from scratch by power plants. That electricity is electrical energy that was converted from other forms of energy. In the case of windmills and hydroelectric dams, that electrical energy was converted from the energy of motion, also called kinetic energy. In the case of fossil fuels, that electrical energy was converted from the energy in chemical bonds, also called chemical energy. In the case of geothermal energy, that electrical energy was converted from heat energy. In the case of solar panels and solar thermal energy, that electrical energy was converted from light energy. Each type of energy source has good and bad sides. In cooperation with their citizens, our leaders try to decide on the best energy choices for a given region. With public input, our leaders consider what is readily available, the cost of production, impact on wildlife and the environment. There are never easy choices, but we are very lucky to have many options when choosing our energy sources. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.